this is Joe Osuna. Today's guest is Steve Perez. He's an IT...
Services.
Services. And now you're the manager?
That's correct.
Okay. And the first question is, what does IT mean?
Sure. IT stands for information technology. So the Department of Information Technology Services, we provide all of the computers and the software applications that the Golden Rain Foundation uses. And we support all of the staff with their devices, their workstations, telephones, and of course all of the programs that they use in order to conduct business at the foundation.
Okay. Second question is, all the ladies out there that are unattached want to know if Steve is married. So let's find out once and for all.
I am definitely married to my lovely wife, Gabby. Here's the evidence on my hand.
Okay, ladies, leave him alone. Don't mess around with Steve, because he's got a wife. Okay, now, the reason Steve is here is because there is a great website for Leisure World that a lot of people don't realize exists, and a lot of benefits to it. And Steve is going to tell us all about what that website does and the benefits of it and what features it has. So where do you want to start on the website? First of all, how do you get to it?
Well, there's a history of our website. We've had it established probably for about 10 to 12 years now. And just recently in the past year, we upgraded and enhanced it to a new type of website that gives us a lot more control in our abilities to self-manage and edit it. So the general public has seen the change and transformation of our website to a new format. And it's certainly inclusive of a lot more information that's beneficial to not just the potential resident of the community, but also our existing residents. And within the past 6 months, we've also expanded that so that each of our mutuals within the community have an opportunity to create their own private site. And about half of them have already established that and are taking advantage of this.
Okay, that's interesting. So what would I expect of a mutual that already has a presence in your website?
Sure.
What is there to see?
Well, with the mutual sites, this gives the mutual board an opportunity to communicate directly to their respective residents. So with these private sites, as we call them, the residents of a particular mutual would establish a registered login to their website and then have access to information that their mutual board wants to make available. So that could be inclusive of event information, bulletin board messages, and also minutes of their monthly board meetings, contacts of their mutual board, and some links where the residents can submit information or questions online, comments, directly to their respective board members so they can have that direct line of communication.
So that's neat. So that's something that didn't exist before.
That's correct. That's right. And many of the mutuals in the past have attempted to create their own websites, which they've established. But with this feature, this is a nice amenity that the foundation provides to the mutuals. We support this and purchase this up front and don't charge the mutuals to use this. So this is their opportunity to create and establish an official website tied to our community, and we provide a resource on staff to assist them with the development of their private website.
Okay. About how many mutuals are participating at this point?
About 7 of 16 are actually launched live now with their private site, and about 7 more are in the process or close to launching their website. So we expect that within the next 5 to 6 months that all of the mutuals will have their private sites established and available to their residents.
Okay. A lot of the mutual boards, some have expertise on the internet and others are non-computer users. So how do they get to have that presence on your board? Do you have staff that helps them or what?
Yeah, we obviously communicated to each of the mutual boards the opportunity to establish their private sites through this website feature that we provide for them. And with that, we extend the invitation to key members that they designate to be the contact for their representative of their mutual and to be in touch with our staff. We have a systems analyst who handles that function within our department. So we provide that assistance in establishing a mutual website. And for the most part, we're creating the content, they're providing the information, the text information, the photos, and the type of information they'd like to display in their website. And we establish that on the website. But there are some mutuals who have some representatives that are technically savvy, so we give them the opportunity to self-manage it themselves.
Great. Besides mutuals then having a presence on your website, what other features does your website have?
Well, that's where we open up the conversation to a slew of features and amenities that we provide on our public website. And that's representative of the community as a whole. And with that, I like to call it the marketing site, because it really is a website that provides as much information as possible to the potential resident, those who are shopping for a new home and find Leisure World Seal Beach as a potential community. And within our website, the public website, we have all the information that includes the clubs that over 200 clubs that represents the diversity that we have within our community.
You mean we have 200 clubs in Leisure World?
It's estimated to be about 200.
Wow.
Clubs, yes. And again, that represents so many types of clubs that are established out there, anywhere from card and games to hobbies to social clubs to religious orientation and so many different types of clubs that are available that represents, again, that diversity that we have within our community.
And how do you find a club in your website? What would take us through like a step of,
sure.
I want to find some club there, so what do I do?
Well, we have a couple of links that would direct a resident to, or a potential resident to that section of our website. It would be either on the menu bar that we have at the top, across the top of our website, and there's also a section at the very bottom that gives a little summary about the active lifestyle that we have here in the Leisure World Seal Beach community. And then from there, once they click on that link, then they get a list of all the different groups and types of clubs. And from there, they can get into all the detail of the 200 plus clubs that we have.
Before I get, I have some more questions on clubs. You mentioned marketing part.
Mm-hmm.
That happened, one of our camera people here, Joseph Chavez, did exactly that from New York.
Yes.
He went to your website,
great.
Explored your website, and he was so impressed with the features and amenities here.
Yes.
He immediately flew from New York to California, Seal Beach, California, and purchased the unit over here.
That's
great. Great.
But what you're just mentioning, the fact that Joseph is from New York, we keep statistics on our website, and we're able to see the types of visitors and the locations of our visitors, and it extends beyond the United States. We see visitors from countries around the world.
Wow.
Yeah.
So that's a neat feature. Okay, so not only United States or people in the United States are looking at the website, people in other countries are looking at our Leisure World website.
That's right. And that's why our website is such a great marketing tool, because it extends and reaches out beyond just our local community, but in the United States and again across the world. And I presume that Joseph probably looked at our on-site sales link that we have within our website, and from there he has an opportunity to see and view units that are on sale or for sale through that website.
And he's nodding yes, that's exactly what he did.
Yes.
So that worked. At the success story here, we have one of our camera people that did exactly that. Okay, now did I remember correctly at your website you had something about selecting the language?
That's a very nice feature that has been well received, and again, accommodating to the diversity that we have within our community. It is the Google Translator tool that we've applied to our website. So what it does is they select a list anywhere up to 60 plus languages that they can translate the content of our website into that specific language. And it works very well from page to page, whether it be the home page, some general information to the club sections or the different departments that we have within our the Golden Rain Foundation, all the information can be translated to it, to whatever language is picked from that list.
That's neat. Now, getting back to clubs, I noticed that when I was looking at the list of clubs, some were bright and some were kind of a different color.
What did
that signify?
Yeah, that's where we've extended an invitation to all of our clubs to expand upon the information that we list on our website regarding that specific club. And what that the bright lettering that you notice is actually a hyperlink to an expanded page of information. And so some clubs have done a very good job of including photos, extended descriptions of their clubs, and even video. And I might mention that the video club here, Video Producers Club, is very elaborate on the information and the type of media that they share about their club within their webpage.
Okay, can you walk us through some steps? If I was a club, Brand X Club, and I wanted some video or information about my club on your website.
Yes.
What do I need to do?
Well, if you have a resource or source link of a video, perhaps it's on YouTube, or if you provide a video, that can be submitted to the IT services department, and we can apply that to the web page or the club page.
Okay, so let me stop right there a minute. Okay, that means that my video that I want to show on your website would have to be hosted somewhere else, right?
That's correct.
Okay, you don't host it?
No.
Okay, all right. And I have to provide you a link for that?
Yes.
Okay, so you mentioned YouTube, which is one of the common ones, or Vimeo and a bunch of other stuff.
That's right.
Okay, so the video information resides on that website, and then there's a link, and it appears on your website.
That's right.
So they click on that, and then...
Yes.
And it's
just like you see with YouTube links and other websites. It's an actual snapshot of the video, so that it's not just hyperlinked text,
okay,
but they can see a snapshot of what the video would represent, a title of that, a caption of that video, and once they launch it, it's embedded within that page. They can watch the video while still remaining on that club page.
Yeah, it's a neat feature that each club could be seen throughout the world.
It is, and we're hoping that more and more clubs like the Video Producers Club embrace that technology and opportunity to share more information about their community club.
Now, so far, is there a limitation? What's your policy on that? How many videos? Have you explored that possibility yet or not?
We haven't limited it, and that's exactly the reason why we don't host that particular content or the video files, so that we're not in the business of expanding our storage for our website. It's a simple link to a video source like YouTube, a media site, then it's really limitless. It just be displayed across the page, or the length of the page, as many pictures and video links they want to provide.
Great. Anything else about clubs that I haven't mentioned?
No, I just would extend the invitation to, again, either the local community resident or even the public. They have access to the club information, and just to see the diversity that we have in our community that's represented by all the clubs that we have.
Great. Okay, so we covered the mutuals having a presence, mm-hmm. the clubs having a presence. What else can we dwell in there?
Yeah, well, you know, with the Gordon Rain Foundation, we pride ourselves in being transparent, and we're trying to do as much as possible to share as much information to our community and the public when it comes to public information. So with that, we provide links to business documents, which include our Gold Rain Foundation and mutual policies. There are a directory of policies that would open a PDF so they can review policies of respective mutuals and the Golden Rain Foundation. And then there's also the board agendas and minutes of our monthly GRF board meetings. So those are posted each as they become available, and there's an archive of that. And probably the most popular feature resource that we provide on our website is a link to our GRF News, the newspaper that's printed weekly and dropped on the doorsteps of our community residents. Has been available to the general public now in electronic format through our website, and we keep an archive probably for the past 2-3 years now.
Wow. So I didn't know that.
That's right.
So I've been just reading the paper every Thursday when I get it, but I didn't realize that I could also go on your website. And read the paper that way, too.
Yes, and it's represented very nicely because the color, full color feature of our newspaper is available on the website, and it shows very nice on the computer screen.
Okay, and you mentioned archives, so about approximately how far back do you go?
Yeah, or? If I'm not mistaken, I think it goes as far back as 2011, maybe 2010. Okay. So there's a nice archive there, and again, it's weekly editions, and that is a growing list of GRF news.
That's a neat feature, yeah.
One other doc or link that we've just recently launched is the GRF committees webpage section. So there we list all of our foundation committees, the members of those committees, as well as an opportunity to email individual directors or the entire committee, as well as a list of the committee, I guess that we would call them the agendas, mm-hmm. as well as the minutes. So that's another resource that we make available to our residents.
Gee, that's neat. Okay. Anything else? I mean, you got a lot of stuff there that residents can use.
That's right. I mean, we try to provide as much information as we can to our residents and make it a very useful feature for our existing residents in addition to our potential residents. But that's been the driving force behind the continual development of our website, is to make it very useful and functional for our existing residents. We want them to come back and find everything they need to know about the community through our website. And I know there are plans to continue to grow upon this effort and this idea, and make it as beneficial to our residents as possible.
Great. Anything else in closing, because we're down to about 3 minutes?
Okay. Well, again, I welcome anyone to visit our website. I think they'll find that as you get into deeper and deeper into the different web pages that we have, that you'll find that there's so much more information that the community or the public at large just wasn't aware of. But we do hold a lot of content, and have a lot of information in there that would probably answer many of the questions that the community residents or the public would have.
Okay, anything in the future? Is the website evolving? Is it going to stay the same, or any plans for that that you can talk about?
I'm glad you asked. Right now, as I mentioned, we have our mutuals establishing the private sites, and another amenity that we're looking forward to is the ability to provide our residents an opportunity to look at their account information. So all of the assessment charges or service charges that they might have with the mutuals or the foundation, they will be able to see them online, similar to a home banking access that would have with their financial institution. And again, there's the opportunity to communicate electronically to their board of directors on questions that they may have about the their mutual landscaping, or comments they have about their washrooms, or just questions they have specifically they want to direct to the board. So that collaboration, that ability to communicate online and provide as much information to our residents, that's where we're heading towards.
If people have questions about your website, is there a contact person or on the website to contact that individual?
Yes. Okay. Under About Us, there's an option to click a link that allows them to submit a question. So that comes to the IT services department, and from there it gets distributed accordingly.
Very good. Okay, I think that's about it. Anything else you want to, you only got about 30 seconds left.
I think I've said enough, but I hope that with this, it expands upon the opportunity for more of the public and the residents to be aware of this great amenity we have for the Leisure World Seal Beach community.
Well, I agree, it's fantastic. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome. My pleasure.
Okay.